Welcome to College Football on ESPN, presented by 5-Hour Energy.
It's under a setting sun that two Big East schools look to rise up from the conference cellar. South Florida tries to snap a 6-game losing streak. Meanwhile, Connecticut has lost 3 straight, both the Huskies and the Bulls seeking that elusive first Big East win. Hello and welcome to Raymond James Stadium. And East Schroff here with former Colorado and Boise State head coach Dan Hawkins. For both these schools, they were accustomed to getting to the postseason. They were accustomed to success. Both missed the postseason last year. And if they don't do well down the stretch, they could miss it for a second straight year.
They need to get on a run, and they're struggling right now. South Florida has been really prolific on offense, over 300 yards rushing, struggling a little bit in the turnover category, and they can't stop anybody on defense.
And especially late, South Florida over the last year and a half has rewritten the manual on ripping a fan's heart out, Temple of Doom style. You go back to 2011, 3 games where the Bulls were involved in ended on a game-winning field goal. They lost all 3 of those. This year, they came back in the fourth quarter against Louisville. The Cardinals won the game, and then last week, a heartbreaker against Syracuse. There have been issues defensively, especially against the pass, and now South Florida without its leading tackler, Sam Barrington, today.
Well, they've gone forever without getting an interception. That's hurting them in the turnover category. You've got UConn on the other side, really great on defense, one of the top 10 defenses in the country, but they're struggling on offense. Lyle McCombs, their tailback, normally pretty prolific. He's a little off this year.
Yeah, both Paul Pasqualoni, UConn's head coach, and offensive coordinator George DeLeon told us this week they need to get the running game going. Lyle McCombs, his last 2 games, averaging just 2 yards per carry, and UConn as a team held a negative 6 yards in their last game, a 40-10 loss to Syracuse. We're about ready to kick things off here at Raymond James Stadium. When these two teams played last year, UConn won in East Hartford 16-10. The Huskies won without a single offensive touchdown. South Florida will kick to start the game. UConn to receive.
Really important for UConn to try to find some identity here tonight. They've been all over the board, trying to get their running game, throwing game, just trying to figure out who they are.
And that'll be a touchback, so UConn starts at its own 25-yard line, and Chandler Whitmer, the quarterback of this Huskies offense, redshirt sophomore from Newman, Georgia, started his career at Illinois. Then went the junior college route to Butler Community College. Now here with the Huskies. He's been the starting quarterback all season long. Offensive coordinator George DeLeon said, in Whitmer, you see flashes of brilliance. You also see disaster from time to time. On first down, here's Lyle McCombs. And he picks up a yard. It'll bring up second down and 9. McCombs, the team's leading rusher, a guy that Huskies want to get going again.
That's their style. Feed the tailback, and then get a little play action going off of it.
UConn 0-3 in the Big East. South Florida 0-4. Combs again rumbling through that line, and he gets about 3 more. It'll bring up 3rd down and 6. Luke Sager on the stop. McCombs a year ago, 6 100-yard rushing games. One this season, and talking to the coaches, they said some of it is on McCombs, some of it is on erratic quarterback play, and a lot of it is on the offensive line.
Yeah, they've had a little shuffling going on up front. And you wonder sometimes how much the off-field issues get into a guy's psyche and his mojo and affect his play on the field.
3rd and 7. Whitmer throws. It's complete to Bucky Jones on the reception. And he's going to be short of the first down. So a good sign from this South Florida defense on the Bulls' first defensive possession holding UConn to a three and out.
Talking to defensive coordinator for South Florida, Chris Posh. He said yesterday about simplifying his defense so his guys could play faster and bring in a little bit more pressure, but being simple so they could make some plays.
Cole Wagner kicks it away. Andre Davis will let it bounce. And it bounces out of bounds at the 20-yard line, a 46-yard punt. South Florida's offense takes the field for the first time. And that's quarterback B.J. Daniels for the Bulls, third all-time in the Big East in total offense. Tied for second in school history in touchdown passes. And if he has one more rushing touchdown today, he'll become the school's all-time leader in that category.
He got it going last week, rushed for over 100 yards. His ankle's been banged up a little bit. He's one of the best dual-threat quarterbacks in the country when he's healthy.
And South Florida very effective with that zone read on offense against Syracuse last week. UConn had trouble against that when they played Syracuse. Daniels slings it out. That pushes it to the 30-yard line, a gain of 9. Deontay Welch with a catch.
With the loss of Lindsay Lamar at tailback, who's been very prolific for the Bulls, B.J. Daniels will probably be in the gun more, be a little bit more zone read and quarterback run conscious to make up for the loss of run yards.
Lindsay Lamar, the team's leading rusher, fractured clavicle against Syracuse, out for the year. UConn showing blitz. Instead, it's a give to Marcus Shaw, and Shaw with a nice run. That's a first down, finally brought down by one of the UConn captains, Jory Johnson. No Lindsay Lamar. You see the average yards per carry. That's one of your stats that matter, 7.2. And we're going to see a two-headed monster in the backfield for South Florida. Marcus Shaw, who you just saw, and also Demetrius Murray. But it's Shaw who the team is really looking at as a guy who can come closest to what Lamar gave them offensively. Play action. Plenty of time for Daniels. He'll take a shot downfield. He wants Davis. A lot of contact, but no flag.
Got tangled up a little bit before the ball was in the air. Cleaned it up after the ball was in the air. They'd like to hit a couple of those shots. Stretch out this defense. Defensive coordinator Don Brown from UConn will bring a lot of pressure, so it's going to be important for the Bulls to be able to block that up, get it downfield to help deter some of that pressure.
Pardon me, Welch, the intended receiver on that long passing attempt by Daniels. Second and 10. Again, pressure, Shaw. And he's tackled down by Yawin Smallwood.
Nice open field tackle. Hot throw triggered by bringing five by UConn. B.J. Daniels had to get that ball out quick to order to avoid the sack, and then a great open field tackle by Smallwood.
Yawin Smallwood, the team leader in tackles, ninth in all of college football. That was his 86th stop of the year. Demetrius Murray checks into the game at running back here on third down and 9. Again, pressure from the outside by UConn. Daniels throws incomplete in the direction of Welch. He was covered by Bleedy Ray Wilson.
Good job by B.J. getting outside, resetting his feet. Unfortunately, his receiver fell down on the outside.
So both teams, relatively quick opening drive. South Florida forced to punt it away. Justin Brockhouse kick it away for the Bulls. Nick Williams back deep for UConn. Good high punt by Brockhouse Kahn. Fair catch by Williams at the 15-yard line. And that's where UConn will start. Second possession on offense for the Huskies when we come back.
Guys get Lee.
UConn 0-3 in Big East play for the first time since 2006. The Huskies trying to snap their first three-game losing streak since 2009. We referred to it before we went to break. Hawks stats that matter. Coach, which ones do you key in on?
Well, you can get into a bunch of stats and count things. You know, to me, time of possession doesn't mean very much. But turnovers, South Florida's been not very good in that. Yards per carry, neither one of these teams. UConn, a run-dominated team, has not been very good in it all year. And to compound that, we talked to Paul Pasqualoni. He emphasized field position, and here they are at the minus 15. Not a good start.
First down, Whitmer steps up. Got rid of it to McCombs. The shovel pass gives them about 10 yards. It's going to be close to a first down. South Florida, you talked about on defense, their inability to force turnovers. Only one takeaway since September 13th. They're the only team in the FBS without an interception. Here we are in week 10. And to compound things, their leading tackler, Sam Barrington, suspended for this game for driving with a revoked license. He's apparently done that a few times, according to a team official, and suspended for this contest. And he's a big part of that linebacking core for the Bulls.
They're looking for a breakthrough moment. Trying to get some corner blitz coming off the edge. Good call by Chris Kosh there. Nice job, Kayvon Webster, coming off the boundary side, corner blitz. Nobody saw him coming. Good mix up defensively.
So that brings up second down and 9 for UConn. You talk about the inability to run the football for this Huskies team. To make things worse, one of their top offensive linemen, Adam Masters, done for the season with an ankle injury. He suffered it in UConn's last game against Syracuse. George DeLeon, the offensive coordinator, said that's like losing 4 guys.
Backed up a number, helped rotate and spell some of the other linemen.
Quick screen to Williams, and he's bumped out of bounds at the 26-yard line, a gain of 1. So here we are, 3rd and long for UConn. A situation they said plagued them in that 40-10 loss to the Orange at the Carrier Dome a few weeks ago.
Well, any team's going to struggle in this yardage. And with the way Don Brown's defense been playing for the Huskies, you don't want to put them in a bad spot. So you're better off even if it's 4th down and you have to punt it and play defense for UConn. That's probably a good formula.
You see what UConn has done on 3rd downs this season. Near the bottom of the pack in the FBS. South Florida bringing pressure. Whitmer's got some time over the middle. And that's caught by Michael Smith. A 22-yard pickup for Smith.
Really nice job. Post curl at the top of the play. Coming back downhill just a little bit. Throwing him open. Good job. Defense right on the play. George Baker was sitting right there, but that's a nice catch.
Chandler Whitmer off to a good start. The UConn quarterback, 4-for-4, 39 yards here in the first quarter.
Chandler Whitmer has some arm strength. He can make that wide side throw.
McCombs. He gets about 4. It'll bring up 2nd down and 6.
George DeLeon, offensive coordinator. He coached the Titans, been a line guy, famous, been around the profession a long time for the Huskies. Just trying to find a formula. Knows a ton of offense, but trying to push the right buttons to make this Husky team go.
Yeah, offense has been a huge issue. You're talking about a program right now, 111th in the nation in total offense, 116 out of 120 in scoring offense, 116 out of 120 running the football. Whitmer to Williams. Nice dance step, gets to the outside and bumped down near the 45-yard line. Another 3rd down coming up. It'll be 3rd and about 4.
Put you in a much more manageable position. You can screen here. You can throw a short 3-step pass and get a 1st down. In some cases, if you had a running quarterback, it might be a running down. But 3rd and 4 is markedly better than even when you get into 3rd and 8. Watch corner blitz coming off the boundary here.
Williams in the slot. Whitmer's got some time. And now he'll have to throw it away. 4th down.
Here you go back to the field position battle. They're going to end up punting here, depending on what happens. Forcing South Florida to drive the length of the field against a defense that's been pretty good for the Huskies.
Paul Pasqualoni, more wins in the Big East than any other coach, 65. But getting to 66 has been tough, 0-3 in league play this year. Second punt of the game for Wagner. And that one goes out of bounds. South Florida will have it at the 20-yard line when we come back. Scoreless first quarter at Raymond James. ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Hours and hours of energy. Scoreless first quarter, South Florida playing host to UConn. Both schools trying to get that first conference win of the season. Skip Holtz's squad, it's a banged up one. Against Syracuse, Lindsey Lamar lost for the season with a fractured clavicle. He was their leading rusher. Starting tight end Evan Landy, he's out as well. He was hurt during that game. Derek Hopkins suffered a leg injury. And then one of their starting offensive linemen, Danis Estenor, also injured against Syracuse. So you look at that offensive line right now, three sophomores and two freshmen making up that five-man unit against a pretty good UConn defense.
Started a while back when offensive lineman for the Bulls, Mark Popett, got hurt. Then they activated redshirt freshman Thor Joswiak came in there. You've got Rinyard Goodmanson. You mentioned Estenor out. You've got Max Lang trying to sub in there, as well as Lawrence Martin. That's hard when you've got five new bodies in there.
And this UConn defense, number 10 in the nation in total D. Daniels over the middle. That's Mark, and he takes it to the 38-yard line, a gain of 19. 10th catch of the year for Victor Mark.
Really nice job by BJ, seeing the defender walk up, bringing pressure from the top of the screen, zone blitz, throwing it in the soft spot.
Moving the ball on offense has not been a problem for South Florida this season. It's been the other side of the football. And not much there for Demetrius Murray. It'll bring up second down. Angelo Pruitt with the tackle.
The Bulls have been getting in the I formation a little bit more when they had Lindsey Lamar and trying to take the running pressure off of B.J. Daniels. As we mentioned at the top, getting a little bit more in the gun and maybe seeing some more zone read quarterback runs to augment the rushing performance.
UConn rushes five. Daniels gets rid of it, and Mitchell tackled immediately. Lady Ray Wilson there on the stop for the Huskies.
Really nice job early on. UConn has been bringing almost five rushers every single time, and between BJ and the O-line picking it up and getting the ball out early.
Daniels pumps over the middle, and that's caught. Andre Davis, and he takes it inside the UConn 40. Huskies defensive coordinator Don Brown told us that against South Florida, his team has to eliminate the big plays.
Andre Davis, one of his more reliable targets, he's been a little bit dinged up as well.
South Florida picking up the tempo here on offense. Not much there on first down. Just getting back to the line of scrimmage is Demetrius Murray.
See B.J. Daniels after that play waving his arms and clapping to the sideline. Nobody had me on that, so expect him to pull it and keep it here at some point on the zone read.
Marcus Shaw checks into the game as the running back.
Counting on Marcus Shaw, he's the quicker of the two to kind of replace some of the speed that they lost when Lindsey Lamar went out.
UConn again showing blitz here on second and 10. Corners playing press coverage. Daniels gives it up to Shaw, and he gets it down to the 31-yard line. 2 yards shy of the first down. It'll bring up third and two.
Really good audible there. UConn showing zero blitz, which means everybody's manned up, and they're going to bring it. They're running speed option. That's a tough play against a defense that's blitzing and playing zero on the back end.
And B.J. Daniels, a major threat in the running game, over 100 yards on the ground in South Florida's last game. He's done it eight times, in fact. A little bit of room there for Shaw. Make it Murray. And he's out of bounds. It'll be first down and goal for South Florida. Demetrius Murray. Normally, he's your 4 yards in cloud of dust.
Another pressure look. This is the disadvantage. If you don't get a stop at the line of scrimmage, there's plenty of space to get moving.
Daniels will keep it and into the end zone for a Bulls touchdown.
There it is, and we knew that was coming.
With that last rushing touchdown, B.J. Daniels has the most career rushing TDs in school history. That was his 25th, breaking a tie with Andre Hall.
really like BJ. He's got a smooth stroke. He can throw it, and he's very prolific. Long as he can stay healthy, he's a major threat, both throwing and running.
Mikon Bonani, the reigning Big East Special Teams Player of the Week, on for the point after. Drilled 5 field goals, a school record last weekend. 8 plays, 80 yards, on 3 minutes and 14 seconds. Demetrius Murray with a nice run. And then B.J. Daniels, the quarterback keeper, to cap the drive. B.J. Daniels with a touchdown run for South Florida. And as we mentioned, he is now the school's all-time leader in rushing touchdowns with 25. Look at where he ranks in total offense. That's in Big East history. And he has a big day today. He's got a chance to surpass Pat White, former West Virginia quarterback, and move into second place all-time on the total offense list in conference history.
Good thrower, good runner. As we mentioned, he had over 100 yards last week. Capable of making the long run as well. He has speed.
And how about tempo for South Florida on that last drive? It seemed to throw that UConn defense a little bit.
Well, anytime you try to bring a bunch of pressure, you've got to communicate, you've got to adjust the formations, get on the same play. That's why a lot of people do it. They try to get a vanilla look out of that defense.
South Florida fans, they're watching this. They see their team with a 7-0 lead, and part of them is saying, we've seen this movie before. The Bulls get a lead. They had a 20-3 lead against Syracuse. The Orange came back in the second half. They rallied from 11 down in the fourth quarter against Louisville to take the lead, only to see Louisville win at the end. It's that wait-and-see approach. Talking to some people in Tampa familiar with the Bulls, they say, we don't like to get ahead of ourselves.
Well, fortunately for South Florida, UConn has not been very prolific on offense yet this year. What South Florida needs, they need that key interception. They need that interception, a little momentum to break into that next level.
Taylor Mack downs it in the end zone. UConn will start at its own 25. Connecticut, one of the areas affected by Hurricane Sandy. Paul Pasqualoni's team was coming off a bye week, but they had to push back practice on Monday. Really couldn't get any work in. And if you want to donate, go to the Red Cross's website at www.redcross.org or call 1-800-RED-CROSS. You can text Red Cross to 90999. To donate $10. Certainly, you know, you've seen the devastation in the pictures in the tri-state area, but really 9 states affected by Sandy's wrath, and we would appreciate anything you can do to help out as the Eastern Seaboard tries to recover. Whitmer on first down finds his tight end, Delahunt, and he's to the 40-yard line, a 15-yard pickup.
Good job throwing into the hole of the pressure. Most offensive coordinators, wherever the pressure comes from, that's the area you want to throw into. Good play fake, good seam throw.
Whitmer off to a good start, 6 of 7, 56 yards.
Huskies will bring the whole kitchen sink. They'll, a lot of formations, a lot of different plays.
Solid run on first down by Lyle McCombs. Give him 6, second down and 4.
They like that one back power. They like the two back power as well, but pulling the offside guard, that's the staple of this offense. And then trying to get multiple formations and shifts.
And you talked about South Florida's defense not forcing turnovers, 0 interceptions. We talked to the coaches. They said that's not all in the DBs. They need to get pressure up front. The front 7 has to do its part.
Really nice job bringing the corner off the edge again. Got to be able to adjust to that and flip the ball outside the receiver. Rashard Clayette in there coming off the edge.
Front 7 doing its job there. It'll bring up third down at about 5.
Two contrasting styles. UConn a huddle team, more of a pro set, multiple formation, and then on USF you've got the no huddle spread look.
Here comes the pressure, and down goes Whitmer. D.D. Lattimore with a sack for South Florida.
Pressure coming up inside, bringing blitzers inside. Too many to block for UConn. Good job. Need an audible out of that or have a hot throw ready.
So UConn forced to punt it away again. Third punt of the game for Wagner. Andre Davis waiting for it back at his own 20 for South Florida. Davis lets it bounce.
Got to go catch that. Cannot let that ball hit the ground. Got to go get it. That guy's blocked. He might have had a chance.
Down to the 22-yard line. We remind you, College Football Daily is your destination for all the latest reports and analysis. Our experts dissect all the storylines and breaking news each day. College Football Daily, weekdays at 1 Eastern on ESPNU.
Got a little overtime action going up in South Bend. Big game in Baton Rouge.
One out on the West Coast, too. A couple of teams playing, you know. Might have some impact on the Pac-12 race. Play action. Daniels over the middle. And that's caught. Victor Mark again. And that's a South Florida first down. A 15-yard pickup.
Little naked bootleg. We've got a dragger coming off of the backside over here. Nice job by BJ setting his feet, throwing it in the open area. Good play action, good pocket movement.
Daniels will bubble screen that time. And nowhere to go for Deontay Welch. He lost the yard. UConn all over that.
Wayne Gratz did a nice job playing off the block. You see the zip that BJ Daniels can put on the ball, but really good job by Gratz getting off that block.
There is a flag on the play at the 35-yard line.
After the play, personal foul. Defense. Number 38, hands to the face, 15-yard penalty.
Alex Cantor
giving him the business, as they used to say on NFL films.
So South Florida now into UConn territory after the penalty. Marcus Shaw for 2 yards up the middle. It'll bring up second down and 8. Shamar Steffen with the tackle for the Huskies.
UConn kind of backing off a little bit, playing more of a two safety high look, not blitzing as much. They can stop the run up front with the big fellas and don't have to blitz, take a little pressure off the big plays.
UConn number 10 in the nation in total defense, 22nd against the run, 13th against the pass. Daniels completes again. That's Sean Price. And at the 35-yard line is Price, the true freshman, who offensive coordinator Todd Fitch likes very much.
Boy, you watch the body language of B.J. Daniels. Just really composed, feet underneath him, mechanically sound, doesn't smoke every single ball, knows how to touch it. Got a little leadership going. Going to run down the other end of the field.
A strong first quarter for South Florida. B.J. Daniels with a touchdown run. The defense playing well. The Bulls up 7-0 on UConn. South Florida with a 7-0 lead on UConn. Start of the second quarter here at Raymond James Stadium. B.J. Daniels in that first quarter set the school record for career rushing touchdowns. Has USF on the move once again as we start the second quarter.
8 for 10, 77 yards so far. Really doing a nice job distributing the football and then the one rushing touchdown.
Play action over the middle. It's juggled and it's incomplete in the direction of Jeff Hawkins. No relation to Dan.
That's where they're missing Evan Landy. Good little play action to hold the linebacker seam route. throws it right in there. That'd be Evan Landy's play, who's hurt, and he's a go-to guy for them in that seam area with those tight end throws.
It's another Hawkins playing fullback, by the way, too.
He's got to make that play.
He's got a name to live up to.
Unbalanced this time over here to the bottom of the screen. There's the veteran leadership making an audible.
Out of the eye, here's Shaw, gets to the outside, and he's tackled just shy of the 30-yard line. It'll bring up third down and 7.
Good job on the unbalanced. Good job on the unbalanced. UConn ends up shifting over there. BJ comes back to the short side. Not a long run, but certainly productive. It's a manageable third down.
Four receivers set here on third down. Pressure from the outside, and Daniels is sacked by Trevorto Williams. And with that sack, Williams, now UConn's all-time leader in career sacks.
Record breakers everywhere. The nice thing for Coach Don Brown and UConn, they only had to rush 4, and they got home and got the pressure and got the sack, only rushing 4.
Big moment there for number 48 for UConn, Trevorto Williams, passing Mark Michaels for career sacks as a Connecticut Husky. Michaels played for the team in the early to mid 80s. Punt here on fourth down for South Florida. Nick Williams is just going to let this bounce. It won't bounce. South Florida won't let it. The Bulls down it inside the 10-yard line. Coach Hawkins talking about the field position game. South Florida winning that, winning on the scoreboard as well.
Matt Chick back in the studio. A couple of teams trying to remain unbeaten. Oregon, one of those. And here taking on USC, Marcus Mariota to Josh Huff. Huff does most of the work here for the touchdown, 14-3. And in South Bend, Pittsburgh missed a field goal that could have won it in the second overtime. In the third overtime, Notre Dame first and goal at the 1. They're out of a timeout in South Bend.
Thank you, Matt. BCS chaos looked like it might be on the horizon, but Notre Dame now seems to be in good shape. Oregon-USC game. The Ducks need that to move up in the computer rankings. The computers not liking Oregon. The humans do, though. There's Lyle McCombs. He can't get out of the backfield on first down for Connecticut. Second down and long coming up. And, Coach, we've talked about field position. The Connecticut coaches talking to us on having short fields, being able to capitalize. Well, UConn hasn't had a short field yet.
They just don't have much big play ability, so it's hard for them to drive the length of field when you start from your own 21, your own 20, your 23, and your 10. It's hard to put those 14-play drives together and score. Eight carries for 3 yards is not helping you either.
Whitmer steps up, throws long, and it's hauled in. Ryan Griffin, who's played well the last couple of weeks, had a big touchdown catch in UConn's last game. Takes up 27.
Great throw. Under pressure, steps up. Really nice catch. Anytime you've got the DB turned around, makes it difficult for him to make a play on the ball.
That was the safety, Mark Joyce.
Had success passing the ball, but not running it early on.
To the air again. Low throw, incomplete, intended for Martin Hippolyte. Second down and 10. Well, you have this dynamic here. This is a UConn offense that struggled to move the football. A South Florida defense, which has struggled at times to stop the opposition, especially through the air. They don't force many turnovers. Do you take more chances deep?
Well, I think you have to just to be able to spur on your offense. And really, that's sort of the personality of what Connecticut has become. They're not that run-oriented team. Chandler Whitmer is making the things happen with his arm.
Another throw coming from Whitmer. He just has to get rid of that one. Good pressure that time by South Florida. D.D. Lattimore once again chasing Whitmer, third down.
got outside the pocket, so he's able to throw that ball away. He needs to get it past the line of scrimmage if he doesn't have a receiver. See Coach P not real happy, and you see what we've got going on tonight is 25%, which is lower than a struggling 35% on the season.
Three receivers set here on third down and 10. Well, they got pressure from up front. Todd Chandler getting to Chandler Whitmer. Second sack for South Florida. And UConn's got to punt it away.
I think Chandler was a little bit surprised. Little tackle in stunt on the outside. One of the first times in third down that South Florida has elected. See the tackle coming outside, end inside, TE stunt. You see the strength advantage.
Davis to the 32-yard line, flag on the far side of the field.
During the return, illegal block in the back, return team, number two, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Really need to stay away from that penalty, particularly when you're away from the ball. If you're right on it, you might understand it.
You look at these two programs, Connecticut and South Florida, both made the move to the FBS, formerly Division I, at around the same time, UConn in 2002, South Florida in 2001. UConn joined the Big East in 04. They joined actually a year early. Remember, Miami and Virginia Tech left for the ACC. Boston College left after the 04 season. South Florida joining the Big East in 2005, and really both teams have had success in the Big East getting to the postseason, and it was an aberration last year when both missed a bowl game for the first time in a while. Daniels over the middle. Sean Price, the freshman, with his second grab of the game.
Really nice job. Two deep coverage. Safety's out on the hash. The play action holds the inside linebacker. B.J. easily able to throw it over the top into that open area.
South Florida successful using tempo in that first quarter at times. Going somewhat quickly here, Demetrius Murray right up the gut. Give him 5 yards. It'll bring up second down and 5. Yahweh Smallwood with the tackle.
Last two drives, Don Brown has backed off, played a little more two deep, playing with the seven-man front, not blitzing, taking as many chances. Making South Florida earn it underneath and not giving away those big plays.
Daniels will keep this himself. Breaks the tackle across midfield and scampers out of bounds at the 49-yard line. About a yard and a half shy of that first down marker. Heady play there by the senior.
Boy, he looks under control, doesn't he? Just real smooth. Very calm mind, knows what's going on. Able to butt off the tackler and being smart on the sideline. He's healthy, he's a real weapon.
UConn trying to get lined up defensively.
A little different formation with the three receivers and a tight end. South Florida hasn't shown that yet.
There's that zone read, and it's Daniels for the South Florida first down.
Actually ended up just being a lead play off this side over here, leading with the tailback. Over here, designed quarterback run. That's quarterback power pulling the backside guard all the way. Nearly broke it. That's what he's jumping up and down about. He got the first down, but he almost had a touchdown.
Quick release. That ball is deflected. Smallwood got his hand on it. Second down and 10. The linebackers, the strength of this UConn defense.
Coming back to that same action they had before, faking to the back. Smallwood not buying it this time. They're wanting South Florida to run that ball up there and run the zone play up inside a few times, making buy that fake.
Yawin Smallwood, redshirt sophomore from Worcester, Massachusetts. leads the Big East in tackles.
UConn three-man line, showing three-man line. Bring and field blitz.
That's Davis, switches directions. And he's going to be about a yard shy on the first down, third and one after a gain of nine. Jory Johnson took Davis down.
Really nice job by BJ right there. Bring and field blitz, two guys off the edge over on the right-hand side. He immediately recognized that, throws the backside hitch to his veteran. That's a real veteran play, smooth, calm mind.
How about this? They have Murray and Shaw into the game. Shaw the deep back in the eye, Murray in that fullback position. Here's Murray right up the middle, and he's to the 31-yard line, another South Florida first down. Let's go back to that second down play, Coach.
Here's the field blitz coming off the top. Defense is forced to play soft, and we're going to end up running just a hitch route out here. BJ, nice job. Bang. Inside receiver, wasn't the outside receiver, but really recognizing coverage. Good job.
Daniels keeps it on first down, and he gets close to the 25-yard line. Give him five there. Byron Jones made the stop for Connecticut. When these two teams played last year, Jones had the only touchdown for UConn.
Little wrinkle off the zone read there, where the back becomes the outside threat and the quarterback becomes the inside threat. It's a little opposite of what you see in a normal zone read, where the back goes inside the quarterback outside.
We see both running backs again. And that's Shaw, who just gets back to the line of scrimmage. So third down coming up.
Just because South Florida's a spread team doesn't mean they throw it all the time. They had over 300 yards rushing last week. As you saw, they will get in the I formation, which Coach Holtz liked. But they're really in control, really mixing and matching the throws and the runs right now. We'll see if UConn needs to go back to the pressure to try to create some action.
Big third down coming up. Tenth play of the drive for South Florida. That's Mark in motion. Daniels. He'll run. Chased down by Smallwood. And he's got the first down.
Got UConn in man coverage on the back end. Anytime you do that, it's hard because a linebacker has to end up covering the quarterback. And in this case, probably not as fast. Smallwood doing a nice job, but hard to tackle a mobile quarterback getting on the outside.
Daniels, 107 yards through the air, 20 on the ground. And he ran for South Florida's touchdown, the lone score of this game. Here's Murray, that right at the point of attack, maybe a yard. Yawin Smallwood again, he's been all over the field.
This is typically the part of the year of the field where you get in the red area, you get inside that 20. Defense will start blitzing to try to keep you out of that end zone and knock you into a field goal situation.
South Florida has been terrific in the red zone this season. 24 trips inside the 20, 22 times they've come away with points, 16 touchdowns.
See Don Brown, the defensive coordinator of UConn, a great defensive mind, very pressure oriented.
Daniels keeps it again, and that time he's wrestled down in the backfield by C.O. Moore, third and long. Good play there by the Huskies D.
He really loves C.O., could play anywhere. This coaching staff, Coach Paul Pasqualoni, obviously been in the NFL. A lot of NFL experience on the coaching staff. They like C.O. Moore. Got a little bit of blocking on the perimeter. Keep him off you, which is tough to put a receiver on a linebacker.
All right, so you're at the 25 now, third and long. You're thinking 3 points here?
You got Bonani. He was automatic. You do not want to take a sack for sure. This is probably a comfortable field goal. You don't want to push it too much.
Daniels throws, intercepted by Gratz.
Great play, killer. You cannot have this. This is where you have to be smart. Either throwing that ball away, and that's what Coach Holtz is talking about. That's a nice play.
Third interception of the year by the fifth-year senior, Dwayne Gratz.
Great job he does there on this play is keeping his eyes on the football, and he's able to make the interception.
So much attention on the other UConn corner, Bleedy Ray Wilson, but it's Gratz. Hauls it in for the pick. UConn ball off the turnover.
One little joint supplement. You know this powerful little pill is great for your joints. It's great for your cartilage.
Matt Schick back in the studio. Two of the last three trips to Notre Dame, Pittsburgh won. They almost did it again, but here in the third overtime, needing a touchdown to win, Everett Golson on first and goal breaks the plane, and Notre Dame escapes, remains unbeaten, 29-26 in three overtimes. Back to Anish and Dan.
Thank you, Matt. And Notre Dame now 9-0 for the first time since 1993. The way this team has won close games, they don't have Cam Newton, but a little reminiscent of Auburn from a couple years ago.
They get a little confidence going. They find ways to win. They believe that somewhere along the way they're going to make a play to get it done.
South Florida fans thinking, can we bottle up some of that Irish magic? It's been the opposite for the Bulls. Flag on the play.
Well, think about it last year. Notre Dame just couldn't find that play.
Right.
And they were looking ugly, and now they find a way to make a play and get a little confidence and get it going.
Go back to last year's season opener for Notre Dame. Turned the ball over something like four times, lost to South Florida.
Offense, number 72, five-yard penalty, first down.
So UConn backed up 5 yards. That season opener in 2011, South Florida beats Notre Dame. The Bulls got off to a 4-0 start. They look like maybe they're the team to beat in the Big East, and then just stumble to a 1-7 finish. 1-6 in conference last year. 0-4 in league play this year. Here's McCombs on first down. He's got nowhere to go. That's Chandler again with the tackle after a gain of about 2, second down and 8.
We talked before about the field position game. Once again, they're starting really not from the 20 because of the penalty. They're back on the 15. And UConn just not really equipped to drive the length of the field and score without a mistake coming in there.
Whitmer pumps, throws over the middle. He's got Jeremy Davis. And that's
nice
a catch.
Nice ball. Got a dig route coming in up top. Ends up getting pressure. Had to clutch just a little bit. Got the dig route coming here. Gets a little pressure inside. Does a nice job stepping up, making that throw. That's where the quarterback makes his money. Good job releasing back inside.
We get our first look now at the Wildcat quarterback for UConn, Scott McCummings. Cummings picks up a couple. It'll bring up second down and 8.
Didn't account. Didn't account for the extra defender coming off the edge as South Florida blocked the safety down and brought him off the edge late.
McCummings, a change of pace guy for UConn the last couple of years. When Johnny McEntee started at quarterback last year, McCummings would come in on those wildcat plays, maybe for a series. Hasn't been as effective in that role this year. Whitmer back in. And that's Davis. And he's close to a Huskies first down.
Really good job battling. South Florida bringing 5 again. Because of the closeness of the formation over in the right side, we're able to chip their way out and give Chandler a little bit more time to make that throw under some pressure.
It is a UConn first down. Whitmer 9 for 12, 107 yards, but it's McCummings back into the game for UConn.
South Florida checking to that. They're getting down and putting 8 in the box.
McCummings keeps it, has a little bit of room into the second level. And McCummings down close to the 30-yard line, a 25-yard pickup. Finally brought down by George Baker.
Really nice job, South Florida, crowding the box. We're running the back across this way. He hits it up inside. With the tight end pulling. Good wrinkle.
Just like South Florida's looking for a spark on defense, UConn searching for that spark offensively.
Might have found it a little bit there.
McCumming still in the game.
Same play.
And he falls down that time right at the 31. A loss of a yard, second down and 11.
Lyle McCombs running free outside was looking back going, why didn't you hand that ball to me? But if you get it on the Wildcat, chances are you want to keep it.
And on second and 11, Chandler Whitmer checks back in. Those rush yards, only 21 for UConn, but they had minus six in their last game. Whitmer under pressure, and he just has to get rid of it.
Got to find a way to answer. Rashard Klein again off the edge. Love bringing that corner blitz off the edge. Adding the extra defender. UConn's had a hard time seeing it and hadn't really had an answer. Normally teams will throw a hitch or a slant outside to beat that.
And here we are with UConn, another third and long. These were the situations that plagued them in their last game.
This is really tough. You need a really experienced offensive line and tight ends and back to pick up the pressure looks to give you time to throw it.
Snap goes over the head of Whitmer, and he falls on it back in South Florida territory. UConn was probably at the very end of field goal range for them from where the ball was. Now they're way out of it.
Not as easy for that center, particularly when you put a defender up on him. He gets nervous. Tyler Bullock with the errant. Unfortunately, the only time we get an ISO shot on the guys, but he makes a bad snap. Those four guys blocking a good play don't get much pub, and when it's bad, they get the camera.
A 19-yard loss on that play. Fair catch signal by Davis at the 14. South Florida will start inside its own 15-yard line. Connecticut trailing 7-0.
I'm Matt Schick back in the studio. Coming up at halftime, drama in South Bend as Notre Dame escapes. We'll show you how they did it in multiple overtimes. Alabama and LSU about to get underway, and USC Oregon in a Pac-12 game with BCS implications. See you at half.
All right, Matt, we're flying along here at Raymond James Stadium. A minute 17 left here in the first half. South Florida still waiting to get that elusive first interception on the season. And Hawk, your first stat that matters is turnovers, and that's something that's been a problem for the Bulls all season.
Kill them. You can't be minus 12. You look at the great teams in the country, you look at those top 10 teams, they're going to be all those BCS teams not turning the football, and it's even more deadly in the red zone.
Daniels flushed. Leads to Davis. He steps out of bounds at the 21-yard line, a gain of seven.
Really important to keep a quarterback like B.J. Daniels inside the pocket there. Can't let him get outside. Stats that matter, that big turnover in there. Obviously, UConn built to run, and that's not going to get it. Third downs, they've been struggling all year and continue to do so.
Davis again open on that near side. There is a flag on the play.
Patient job by B.J. Surveying the field and then taking the check down.
Holding. Offense. Number 70. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
That's the right tackle, Quintarius Eatman. He came on campus weighing 362 pounds. He's 6 feet 6 inches, so a big kid. He slimmed down all the way to 301.
Schmelt. Going against Trevardo Williams, not an easy task. Trying to protect his quarterback.
Daniel steps up, and that's incomplete intended for Andre Davis. So we've talked about field position, Coach. Third and long. UConn's got all three timeouts. You make South Florida punt here. If you get a stop, all of a sudden you've got a chance right before the half with a short field potentially.
Yeah, neither team has. The best field position's been at the 25 after the five possessions by both teams so far, and Coach P wanted that short field. If they're able to stop them here, they quit blitzing and kind of playing too deep and playing soft and keeping things underneath them and chasing it down.
instead a run play and not much room for Marcus Shaw. Fourth down coming up. And let's see if UConn calls a timeout. They do. So the Huskies stop the clock with 41 seconds. They'll get the ball back with two timeouts.
Great clock management. Should be able to get a pretty short field here. 41 seconds, two timeouts. You're going to get probably in the 5 to 6 play range here if you manage the clock right.
Hey, two conference champions will be crowned tomorrow on ESPNU at 1 p.m. It's the ACC Women's Soccer Championship, and at 3:30 p.m., the SEC Women's Soccer Championship will be settled. Women's Soccer Conference Championships at 1 and 3:30 Eastern tomorrow on ESPNU. Justin Brockhaus-Kahn will punt from his own end zone. Nick Williams waiting at his own 49-yard line for UConn.
Elects to stay in a return mode.
Williams dropped it, recovers though. Nearly a dangerous moment there for the Huskies, but they're able to hold on to it, and they'll have the ball at 49.
The elbow's inside the frame. Took his eyes off just the last second, but 51 yards, plenty of time, couple timeouts, manage it effectively, should be able to get points on the board.
Williams has had a knack the last couple weeks of covering up his own mistakes against Syracuse. He fumbled. It looked like it was all Syracuse players around it. Somehow was able to recover it.
This is one of the situations where the Bulls' defense has really struggled holding people at the end of the half and end of the game. They've managed to use the clock wisely and score on them. See if they can get a stop here.
That's a first down for Lyle McCombs. He'll momentarily stop the clock.
Clock should have stopped on the first down, did not.
Whitmer throws, incomplete, intended for Williams. Good coverage there by the South Florida DBs, Joyce and Baker.
Ball tipped there a little bit. Try to get in those DBs' mindset to go catch that thing and not just tip it.
UConn's got it at the 39-yard line. And now a timeout by Paul Pasqualoni. UConn kicker Chad Christian has missed 3 of his last 5 field goals. And on the season, just 1 for 6 from beyond 40 yards. So manageable field goal range for UConn. You've got to maybe temper your expectations a little bit. Christian had that terrible game against Temple where he missed 4.
Like to see that number there be more about 85. 12 seconds, one timeout. You probably have an opportunity for one throw and then get your field goal team on the field. So try to get an out route. It doesn't matter. You've got the one timeout. Try to get another 10 yards. Give your kicker a chance.
Middle of the field in play. Instead, it's to the sideline, and McCombs, he gets out of bounds with 7 seconds left in the half.
Now you get in this area, you're rolling the dice just a little bit. You could throw a quick out and still have some time, but if you double clutch on it or something goes wrong, you go in at halftime with no points. They're bringing out the field goal team.
Yeah, they'll bring out the kicking team. Ball right now is at the 33-yard line, so you're looking at a 50-yard field goal. Christian's season long and career long is 47. As we told you, just 1 for 6 beyond 40. Gets his leg into this one, and he gets UConn on the board.
Drama majors there in the end zone. Those officials were not giving it to us early. Nice job. 50-yard kick, a little bit low. Thought it might have a chance to get tipped to the line of scrimmage. Great hold.
Sneaks it in.
Cole Wagner doing a nice job reaching back over his shoulder and getting that ball down.
Christian was a kid after he missed 4 field goals against Temple, which cost UConn that game. He was one of the first guys in the interview room, answered all the questions, stood there. And Paul Pasqualoni stood by his kicker when he was asked if he's going to make a change at that position. He said, no, he's our guy. It's not how we do things. We believe in him. And That faith rewarded there, a 50-yarder with 2 seconds to go in the first half to get the Huskies on the board.
Trust and confidence is such a big thing. You've got to credit him for stepping up and being a man and taking the heat. And you got to credit Paul Pasqualoni for standing behind his kicker when he was struggling. Not easy.
2 seconds left in the half. Let's see if UConn just does a squib kick here. They do. Fielded by Price. Lateral it off. Mitchell down at the 20, and that takes us to the end of the second quarter. South Florida getting a touchdown run from quarterback B.J. Daniels. UConn a field goal late in the half. Now we go to the studio and Matt Schick for more on the drama in South Bend.
Welcome back to College Football on ESPN, presented by 5-Hour Energy.
Daniels will keep it and into the end zone for a Bulls touchdown.
5-1-5-0, just a side of logo. I'm going crazy, thinking about you, baby. 5-1-5-0, just a side of logo. I'm going crazy, thinking I love you, baby.
We're getting ready for the start of the third quarter here at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, and South Florida with a 7-3 lead on UConn. Both these teams looking for their first Big East win of the season with Dan Hawkins and East Schropp. You look at the first half, both teams played it pretty close to the vest.
Trying to scrap out a win. Both of them need it. 2 yards rushing by UConn, not so good. Long field, not what Coach P wanted. Pretty productive day for South Florida, but the end zone interception hurt him.
Let's take a look at today's game track brought to you by Taco Bell. South Florida getting on the board first. B.J. Daniels with a touchdown run. But then Daniels made a mistake here with South Florida in field goal range. Ill-advised throw. It's picked off.
Can't throw it away like that in the red zone. You've got to get your team some points.
And then UConn finally had a short field right before the half. Chad Christian tucks in a 50-yard field goal for the Huskies' lone score. UConn will kick off to start the second half. Paul Pasqualoni's team on a 3-game losing streak. We saw Skip Holtz a moment ago. His South Florida team, losers of 6 straight. Terrence Mitchell, the deep man for the Bulls. A yard deep in the end zone. Mitchell crossed the 20-yard line. And he's to the 26-yard line. That's where South Florida starts. B.J. Daniels in that first half of 11 of 17, 114 yards through that interception. And we showed you the rushing touchdown. Daniels doing it with his legs as well.
Best field position of the day.
This South Florida team has lost 12 of its last 13 conference games, 6 in a row. Marcus Shawn, first down, tackled by C.O. Moore after a pickup of a yard.
UConn went away from pressure after the first couple drives because they were giving up some big plays. We'll see if they stay with the 4-man front, kind of a 2-deep shell, and try to keep things in front of them.
Daniels changing the play here on second down and 9. Under center this time. Play action. Daniels throws, caught by Welch. Tackled by Gratz, but South Florida into UConn territory, a first down, a gain of 29.
Really nice seam route. This is how you turn it over against a 2-deep look. Got a P9, protection 9 outside route, fitting it right in. That's a great catch and a great throw.
UConn defensive coordinator Don Brown said his team had to take away the big plays from South Florida. Nothing there for Marcus Shaw. Second down coming up.
Really nice adjustment by Don Brown early in the first half. South Florida went with that same formation. They were short-handed over the tight end and able to get that solved at halftime.
South Florida's leading rusher, Lindsey Lamar, out for the season. Fractured his clavicle in the loss to Syracuse last week. So it's Shaw and Demetrius Murray now getting the bulk of the carries. Daniels dumps it off to Shaw, breaks one tackle. Still on his feet across the 40-yard line, and it looks like he may have lost his shoe in the process. Somebody lost their shoe. It was Yowen Smallwood.
Really impressed with B.J. Daniels' progression, how he looks at the field and the coverage. Not afraid to check it down, take what the defense gives him.
Third down coming up for South Florida. So far today, 5 for 9 on third down. They've been very good and really very good all season in these situations. 48% coming in.
UConn electing to rush four again and getting there.
And this time they get Daniels.
Got to throw that ball away. Get outside the pocket. Got to throw that thing away.
Ryan Worth with the sack.
Going to see pressure come off the outside. B.J. gets outside of it. You want to keep contained. And he needs to throw that ball away right there. Avoid that loss.
Gervardo Williams with the initial pressure. He had a sack earlier in this game. The school's all-time leader in that category. South Florida forced to punt it away. Fair catch signal by Nick Williams. Had trouble fielding the last punt. Holds on to that one. And UConn again looking at a long field, which, save for their last drive of the first half, that's kind of been the story for the Connecticut Huskies so far today.
They've had a hard time moving it. Chandler Whitmer's thrown the ball well. As we mentioned, 2 yards rushing doesn't bode well for your offense. If they can manage to protect on the edges particularly, which is where South Florida's been getting, they can throw the ball down the middle. They did a nice job with the tight end seam routes.
UConn in the second half has been shut out in its last three games, all against Big East opponents. The last time they scored a point in the second half, you got to go back to September 29th against Buffalo. As Whitmer chucks it away on first down, South Florida again bringing pressure.
Haven't really been able to handle the edge. You need to be able to get a tight end or a fullback in there and protect it, or you have to throw hot.
When we spoke to Chris Koch, the defensive coordinator for South Florida, he mentioned the struggles of this USF pass defense, but said it wasn't just the four guys in the secondary. They needed to generate more of a pass rush. They've actually done a pretty good job of that today.
They really have, and he's done a nice job mixing up where the pressures come from. They brought some corner blitzes as well as edge blitzes from the linebackers. Looks like that's what he's going with again here.
Pressure off the edge. This time it's caught by Jeremy Davis. And he's got a UConn first down, give him 12 yards. The Huskies move the chains.
Webster fell down on the ground. Comes out here throwing just a chain, a spot route out over here to the left-hand side. Good pick up there. Webster on the ground, able to get that ball completed when he's on the ground.
There's Scott McCummings, the Wildcat quarterback, back into the game. He had 3 rushes for 26 yards in that first half.
You can see South Florida pointing. They've got an adjustment. They crowd the line of scrimmage.
Cummings taken down at the 26-yard line. D.D. Lattimore and Corey Grisham right there.
Shark Fayette getting a little pop in there. Close to being a helmet-to-helmet call right there.
Not much on that run, so Whitmer back in here on second down and 9.
This is where in these situations the pressure gets to the quarterback and he's not able to throw the ball farther down the field. That becomes an issue.
Whitmer has some room, middle of the field, and he'll slide down at about the 34-yard line. Going to be a couple yards shy of that first down marker.
South Florida bringing 5. Good job by Chandler being smart, getting up the field. He's not on the field to be the runner. They want him to be the thrower. Didn't want to take any more shots than he has to.
Another third down here for UConn, just 1 for 6 in the first half. And on the season, they came into this game at 36%.
Little easier, 3-2, your whole playbook's available to you.
The throw. Whitmer finds the tight end, Griffin, and he's out of bounds, but he's got a UConn first down, so all Pasqualoni's Huskies convert on third and short.
Good sign for them. Now, if nothing else, if they don't get any points, at least they can kind of keep the field position battle going.
Scott McCummings once again into the game for UConn. This is McCombs. Ran into a lot of green jerseys. Forward progress will get him back to the line of scrimmage, second and 10.
South Florida checking, really in that case, to a nine-man front. Look for UConn to pull the ball and throw it. Maybe in the next time they go Wildcat, anticipating a lack of coverage on the back end.
Whitmer back in on second and 10. A lot of different looks from this UConn team, as Paul Pasqualoni will tell you. They're multiple. Play action. Hauled in by Davis. And he's in South Florida territory. Jeremy Davis.
Really nice job picking that up. Coming outside, throwing a stop route. DB on the ground again. Unable to get out of the backfield. You see him turning and running. Slips and falls down, unable to break on the ball.
Those two, Jeremy Davis and Chandler Whitmer, both from Georgia. They live about an hour away from each other and spent some time meeting up halfway to work on some chemistry over the summer. McCombs finds a little bit of room, and he's across the 45-yard line, a gain of five. Second and five for the Huskies coming up.
That's kind of how he was last year when he was really productive. Just scrappy, not anything really prolific, but every time you looked at the chains, it was a 5-6 yard run.
More than 1,100 yards a year ago for Lyle McCombs, all-conference selection, a freshman All-American. He was just the second UConn freshman to run for 1,000 yards in a season. Hasn't been that kind of year for McCombs this season, though. McCombs gets three more. It'll bring up third and short. Lattimore with the tackle.
South Florida continuing to bring some pressure off the edge, usually bringing five and bringing an inside defender.
So in this drive, we've seen a couple of third downs for UConn, but third and much more manageable than what we saw in the first half.
Third and four, you can take a three-step drop. You can see they're in 10 personnel, which means one back and four wide receivers. Don't have to max protect. You can get it out early and still have a chance to get it.
Whitmer may have had some room to run, but he finds Nick Williams, and that's another UConn first down. He's a guy, offensive coordinator George DeLeon, said that UConn has to find a way to get him the ball more on the offense. He's a terrific special teams player. They want to find ways to get him the ball in space.
Chandler Whitmer doing a nice job distributing the ball to a lot of different receivers. They're mixing it up with some short throws and some intermediate throws and a variety of formations.
Back to the Wildcat and McCummings here on first down. McCummings, he's going to throw it. He has McCombs, who can't hold on.
You
there is a flag. There is a flag.
Legal hands and face. Offense, number 65, 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's Gus Cruz, the right guard, starting
double
in place of Adam
whammy.
Masters.
Leak and Combs outside the backfield, showing, running power up inside. He's got him. Nice throw. The double whammy. Penalty right there coming at you. Drop ball, personal foul.
That was only McCummings' third pass attempt of the season. It won't count now, but, you know, we talked about the line play for UConn. Cruz starting in place of Masters, who was a senior captain and kind of a stalwart on that offensive line for the Huskies. He's out with an ankle.
These kind of situations will end up hurting you when you're trying to find a way to win.
That's hauled in on the far sideline by Nick Williams.
There you see the strength of Chandler Whitmer's arm. Not a lot of guys can make that wide side throw off the hash mark. Off the right side here, throwing the ball on an out route all the way across the field. That's a long throw, pretty accurate with it. Got to think you're probably in four down territory, so you got three downs to get the first, so you can continue to stay in normal mode here.
Whitmer throws Jeremy Davis. Another big catch for Davis, the sophomore from Lawrenceville, Georgia.
Chandler Whitmer showing up. Really good job with the fake. South Florida continue. That's a big time throw. It's not 7-on-7. The great quarterbacks can stand in there and take some licks and under pressured arms and be able to find those throwing lanes.
This is the deepest UConn has been in South Florida territory. McCombs to the 20-yard line, 2nd and 9 after a pickup of a yard.
Really nice drive Connecticut's got going. They can punch this in. This would help them and be a big momentum, big confidence booster because they had to come from a long way away to get it done.
UConn this season, 21 trips in the red zone, 17 scores, only 10 touchdowns though.
Look for South Florida to start heating up here, try to drive them back out of field goal range.
McCombs out of the eye, tackled right at the 20-yard line. Nice stop by Mike June.
Really good job reading that play, running that power over to the right-hand side, reading that pull, and hitting that gap, penetrating, playing on the offensive line of scrimmage.
June is a senior, a former junior college All-American at Independence Community College.
Jayhawker League.
Timeout with 4:36 to go here in the third quarter. A big third down for UConn coming up. The Huskies on the move.
Guys get Lee.
With Dan Hawkins and Ish Schroff, UConn trying to extend its best drive of the game. 14 plays, 66 yards, facing a big 3rd down and 9 against the South Florida defense.
I don't think you have to go for the first down right here. I think you try to get a productive play, get yourself in striking distance, and then see if you've got a 4th down play and go ahead and go for it. If not, you kick the field goal from here. But if you get close, I think you might see the offense stay and think about going for it on 4th.
On 3rd downs today, UConn 3 of 8, but 2 of those conversions on this drive. And Chandler Whitmer has had a pretty good game passing the football, 17 of 23, 191 yards. Running game, been
not
absent
so
for the most part again.
He's been really smooth, made a variety of throws, touch throws, long throws.
Whitmer's got time. Well, that time he throws it behind Nick Williams. And now 4th down coming up, and Chad Christian looking at a 37-yard field goal attempt.
Good job on the pickup and the protection. Just missed a little bit on the throw, and I think they were thinking along those same lines. Probably would have been 4th and 2, 3-ish, and have a chance to go for it, but obviously kicking the field goal here.
A 37-yarder for Christian. He hit from 50 with 2 seconds to go in the first half. Drills it from 37, so a couple of field goals. And UConn has scored 6 unanswered. The All-State Good Hands Field Goal Net Program is something that we're all proud of. All-State has donated more than $2.9 million to the general scholarship funds for universities for every extra point and field goal kicked this season. 1-point game here in Tampa. South Florida, the home team, up by 1, 7-6. A Chad Christian 37-yard field goal has pulled UConn to within 1, and those 3 points, the first point scored in the second half by UConn in more than a month. In fact, it's the first time they've scored in the second half against a Big East team this season, in their previous 3 games shut out in the second half. That's why they're 0-3 in conference.
Really nice drive, 16 plays, 66 yards, took 7:39. That's about 5 of Oregon's drives.
They're
right
being
there.
Kind. 5 on a slow day for Oregon.
slight edge over USC at halftime right now.
Marcus Shaw thought about running it out. Downs it in the end zone. South Florida will start at its own 25-yard line. The Bulls with a one-point lead. UConn and USF both looking for that elusive first conference win. BCS Countdown is on ESPN and ESPNU tomorrow, a day after the dust is settled. Our analysts break down the key wins and defeats from the weekend and their impact on the BCS standings. Who rises, who falls? Plus, a look ahead to the key matchups next week. BCS Countdown at 8:30, then at 9, presented by Discover Card. It's on ESPN and ESPNU. Looking at South Florida's remaining schedule after UConn, they visit Miami, at Cincinnati, and then close the season against Pittsburgh. The Bulls have to win out. They have to go 4-0 to become bowl eligible. Otherwise, they'd miss the postseason for a second straight year. And I got the Jim Mora soundbite in my head. You're talking about playoffs, playoffs. I'm just trying to win one game. That's dropped by Price, second down and 10. We saw South Florida last week in the second half against Syracuse step off the gas a little bit. They allowed the orange to come back. Syracuse down big at the half in that game, and then things kind of fell apart there toward the end.
Coach Pasqualoni talked about making South Florida have a long field, and they've done a nice job. This is the seventh possession for South Florida, and none have started past their own 27.
That time, Shaw unable to get anything on the ground, so two run plays, no yards, third down coming up.
This is where the mobile quarterback can really hurt a defense, because if you play man, he can run for first down. If you blitz and he gets outside of it, can cause you problems.
Daniels, under pressure, gets by C.O. Moore, chased, and nearly intercepted. Byron Jones was right there, and he dropped what was a sure pick.
Great job staying alive. Again, UConn only bringing four, doing a nice job getting pressure against that young offensive line.
Kind of had his hands up.
Would have had a short field there.
Jones had the big play in the UConn-South Florida game a year ago, recovered a fumble, and took it in for a touchdown. That was the Huskies' only touchdown of the game in a 16-10 win. Well, let's see if UConn can build off of their last drive where they went 66 yards, ate up more than 7 minutes of clock.
Not getting a lot of ground yards on the ground. Chandler Whitmer doing a great job distributing the football in a variety of ways, being able to stay off the pressure. This is some of the best field position they've had.
And really, they had a chance for six on that drive when they brought in the Wildcat quarterback, McCombs. Had Lyle McCombs open. McCombs dropped the ball, but it was a penalty against UConn as well. Here's McCombs getting the call on first down. He picks up three, second down and 7.
They will continue to stay patient with that run, even though they're not getting a lot out of it.
Huskies have scored on their last two possessions. Took advantage of a short field before the half to get a 50-yard field goal, and then going 16 plays and 66 yards for a field goal on their last drive. But starting field position hasn't been great, really, for either team. McCombs following his blockers and picks up five more, third and short coming up. And here in the last three or four drives, that's sort of been the difference with this UConn offense. Instead of third and 8, third and 10, we've seen third and 4, third and 2, now third and 1.
Productive on first down, running the football. They're able to have either run or throw in the second down. Makes it a little tougher on the defense. You got your whole playbook available here.
Yeah.
tight ends, two backs. South Florida loading up the box.
Smith in motion. Here's McCombs, and he's got a UConn first down. It's easy when you only have to go a yard, right?
Anytime you put your tailback in at fullback, you got to think he's going to get the ball, probably not going to be the lead blocker.
And McCombs back in that Wildcat package for the Huskies here on first down.
Coaches talk about winning on the road, and one of the elements of winning on the road is being able to run the ball authoritatively in the second half, and you're starting to see a little bit of momentum come to Huskies way because of that run.
McCombs plows forward and can be denied just shy of midfield. Still no whistle there. I'll have to blow the whistle sooner.
A rugby scrum.
He's got a visor, so you can't poke his eyes out.
Quarterback power, a staple of this offense. Great job continuing to churn. Got to get him down on the ground.
That second effort gets UConn into South Florida territory. A 6-yard pickup there from McCombs. Second and four now is Whitmer. Back in the game for UConn as they work out of that pistol.
The other thing with this style of offense is you just slowly sort of break the will of the defense.
Incomplete, intended for Michael Smith. Third down and four, George Baker there to knock it away. And every time you see a South Florida DB break up a pass or get close to knocking one away, you wonder, is this going to be the one? South Florida, the only team in the FBS without an interception this season.
Kind of hangs around. I think the cloud, you mentioned it at the top of the games, they've lost very close at the end and not being able to get an interception. Those things tend to cloud your mind and hang over you, becomes a big old piano sitting on your back.
UConn's converted three of its last four third downs. Whitmer gets rid of it, but Smith is tackled shy of the first down marker by Kayvon Webster. Fourth down.
Offensive lineman wanting to go. Coach Pasqualoni, a little bit old school here. You know, he wants that long field. He's going to go ahead and punt. His defense has been playing well. Keep that field possession in his favor.
He told us this game would come down to field position and said if there's an opportunity to pin the other team deep, make them work and make them drive the field, he was going to do it. So no surprise here. Good punt by Wagner. Lands right at the 5-yard line. So here's that battle of field position, and Pasqualoni's decision to kick pays off. Hawk, let's revisit your stats that matter.
Well, the turnover still looms large. That was points off the board. Neither team running the ball great. Now, those third down conversions have come in this second half, so they've found some answers. And then the conversion, you see UConn yet to get into the red zone. Coach P fired up.
We talk about that long field. That's what South Florida has to deal with. Ball spotted at the 6-yard line.
We talk about field position and the points that come off of it. And really the 20-yard line. Nice play. Good job getting out of a hole. You see the zip on the ball.
That's Terrence Mitchell finally dragged down by Gratz. And a first down. Gain of 15.
But about the 20-yard line is where it kind of starts at zero, and then it's 1 point every 10 yards.
Again, a little quick bubble screen. That's Welch, and he's wrestled down by Ray Wilson. And that takes us to the end of the third quarter in a game that is just zipping along. Here we are going to the final 15 minutes of regulation. This has been the problem area for South Florida. Can they hold on? South Florida is hoping this is the week they can check out of its extended stay at the Heartbreak Hotel. Last year, they lost three games on a field goal, which ended the game. This year, they came back in the fourth quarter against Louisville, but the Cardinals got the last laugh, and then Syracuse shocking South Florida with a touchdown with 3 seconds left last week. Since the start of last season, Coach Hawkins, South Florida has lost six games in which it led in the fourth quarter. You look at just this season, Rutgers, that was a tie game, and then Rutgers scored 10 points in the final 250. The Fighting Lettermans taking down South Florida. Louisville and Syracuse, their last two conference games, trying to change that turn of bad fortune here against UConn. They've got a 7-6 lead to start the fourth. Daniel slings it out to Murray. He's tackled by Ray Wilson. Pickup of 9 yards.
And it looms large in your consciousness. It hangs around. You think about it. The players are thinking about it. The coaches are thinking about it. Trying to shake that bug.
Again, there's that bubble screen. This time, UConn all over it. Gratz, the big play in the backfield. That had been a play that had been working for the Bulls.
Done a nice job getting off that block. Quick screen outside. Better be careful. That might be going six the other way.
Yeah, if that's thrown behind the line of scrimmage, it's technically a run, not a pass. Daniels completes. And that's a South Florida first down. Victor Mark.
Really love how he sets his feet and throws. Even though he's on the move, gets out to his right, setting his feet and able to throw. Normally you would not advise a throw back inside on that type of rollout. When you set your feet, see the field, makes it manageable.
Play action. Daniels pumps. Now he'll tuck it and down he goes. Sacked by Tim Willman.
Trying to get a shot on the outside, but not seeing the big playability of the Bulls in this game. Lindsey Lamar gave them a little bit of that out of the backfield last week. But as we said, he's got the banged up shoulder, not in service for the Bulls.
Yeah, Lamar had an 80-yard run for a touchdown in the loss to Syracuse. That last sack, by the way, the third for UConn in this game.
Don Brown starting to heat it up for the Huskies, kind of getting out of that four-man line. Starting to show more pressure looks.
Incomplete, third down.
Really good job bringing pressure off the edge. Seal Moore getting up in the air, and even though that ball was not batted, he forced him to throw it low and away. Tough place to catch it.
And for all the talk of South Florida's close losses, the offense actually hasn't been the culprit at all. In fact, they've scored. They just haven't had the ball last in most of those instances.
Big third down throw. Have to be careful here. Again, B.J. Daniels' mobility allows him just to use a five-man protection because he can avoid some of the other pressure.
Another shot deep by Daniels. And nearly intercepted. Terrific play on the ball by Tymir Brown.
Similar play. Cover two on the back end. Running the nine route down the sideline. Just got to turn that throw over a little sooner. Right there, he's got to just fit it in that hole. Ball hangs on him.
Almost.
Need to throw that right off the ear of the corner to have a shot at it.
Nick Williams, who had a punt return for a touchdown against Maryland, signals for a fair catch. Talked about the long field for UConn. Their offense the last few times has been able to move the ball a little bit. We'll start inside their own 10 when we come back.
Everybody remembers them.
Thank you, Matt. Louisville off to the best start in school history. They could play Rutgers in that season finale in what could turn out to be a Big East championship game. You see the quarterback comparison, Chandler Whitmer and B.J. Daniels. Whitmer going for Jeremy Davis, who hauls it in. And he's out of bounds, close
what
to the 30-yard line.
And what a great catch. That's a wide side out from the short hash. Coach Pete trusting Chandler. He's having a great game. Drop it back here, a little play action, good protection. Going up, and Davis going up and making a play, getting them out of the hole.
Whitmer's made some pretty good throws in this game, hasn't been intercepted. He'll run. And Whitmer dives out of bounds. About a yard short of the first down marker. Heady play there by the JUCO transfer, Chandler Whitmer.
Chandler Whitmer, one of the best quarterbacks in the country a couple years ago, was an Elite 11 quarterback. Went to Illinois, didn't work out, went the junior college route. Very talented player, and you're seeing the strong arm that he has.
Second down and one. South Florida on defense without Sam Barrington, their weak side linebacker and leading tackler. He's suspended for this game for driving with a revoked license. High snap. McCombs lost it. South Florida says they've got it. And the Bulls on defense create a turnover. Just their second takeaway since September 13th.
And let the celebration begin. Just didn't look like he got it cleanly because the ball is bopping around before he even gets hit.
To Sean Whitehurst, who's playing in place of the suspended Sam Barrington, falling on the football for the Bulls.
You had both teams here, Coach Pete. Unbelievable going against his foreman. Both teams waiting for the other team to make a mistake, and UConn makes one right here.
With Dan Hawkins and Ish Schroff, South Florida nursing a one-point lead. The Bulls haven't scored since the first quarter.
Don Brown starting to bring more pressure.
Shaw, nice change of direction to turn nothing into something. They'll get 3 yards there, second and seven, with Lindsey Lamar out. You miss kind of that electric playmaker in the backfield. But Shaw's the guy the coaching staff says has the ability to be their home run threat in the running game.
Said they didn't think he was as straight out fast as Lindsey, but a guy that had great quicks with his feet.
That's Demetrius Murray, and he just gets to the line of scrimmage. Shamar Stephan with the tackle.
UConn starting to bring more pressure. Yeah, bringing more pressure. This is where the quarterback run hurts you. South Florida needs to convert here, if nothing else, just for the momentum and emotional factor.
They've got a terrific kicker and Mikon Bonani, who had 5 field goals last week. From here, you're looking at about 52 yards if they can't get any yards on this play. Daniels, a little shovel pass. Price with a first down. Still on his feet, taken down to the 22.
Nice wrinkle against the four-man rush. Little shovel pass up inside. Good scheme, good execution. Breaking tackles. That won't make Coach Brown happy.
Price, a freshman, playing more at tight end with the starter, Evan Landy, injured. He's come on the last few weeks. Here's the toss. Murray taken down by Angelo Pruitt and C.O. Moore, a loss of a yard.
Both of these teams being very, very patient with each other on offense. Down inside the red zone, that's where that mobile quarterback can really hurt you because he comes the extra number against a shortened field.
And Daniels is going to take off. He's got the middle of the field. First and goal, South Florida.
There it is. We saw the zone read for the touchdown in the first half. Quarterback draw. The extra blocker.
Well, Coach, I've heard you say it quite a few times. You like a running quarterback, but
don't make him the runner.
And B.J. Daniels, yeah, down at the end of that play. He had an ankle injury that he battled earlier this season. Tackled by Yawin Smallwood.
That's your roll of dice with that. Love to have that guy run, but talking to the coaches yesterday, I didn't really even want to bring up Matt Floyd, who will be the backup quarterback, because you're sort of jinxing. Might have re-injured that ankle he's having issues with.
And boy, that could be a big loss for South Florida. Daniels did have the one interception, but had been playing pretty well and making some good pre-snap reads, changing plays. And we mentioned that he did have the ankle injury earlier this season that he battled.
Looks like Julian Campanini right there landing on his foot.
He's being helped off, and odds probably slim that he returns. So Matt Floyd now, it's his turn at quarterback for South Florida, the redshirt freshman from Milton, Georgia. He's appeared in three games, hasn't thrown a pass since the season opener. And he loses the snap. Ball is still loose. South Florida able to cover it up. So the backup quarterback comes in.
You saw him over there getting snaps. As soon as he saw PJ go down, he was taking snaps. But a little bit jittery.
Right on the exchange, yeah.
Good snap. He's just not quite used to it. I'm sure the performance anxiety curve is kind of pegged. Now he's going to be forced to throw the football if he got a chance for a touchdown.
Second and goal. Give is to Murray out of the pistol. A lot of spinning, but not many yards. A gain of two. Byron Jones in on the stop. As B.J. Daniels covers his head with a towel on the bench. His team facing a third and goal.
Well, you want to be careful here. You've got to feel like with Bonani, you're going to get 3 points if you don't turn it over. Force it into a touchdown game, which UConn has not been able to convert in this game so far.
Floyd's going to throw for the end zone. Too high, intended for Andre Davis. Fourth down, and Mikon Bonani will come on for his first field goal attempt of the game.
Well, the nice thing is he throws it where only his guy can catch it, but unable to come up with a great catch to make that touchdown.
Bonani, the Big East Special Teams Player of the Week, hit 5 field goals in the loss to Syracuse last weekend. For his career, pretty much automatic inside 40 yards, 42 of 45. That's 93%. This is a 28-yarder to make it a 4-point game. And the Brazilian boots it through. 10-6 South Florida, capitalizing off of the UConn turnover. But in the process, the Bulls may have lost their starting quarterback. ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Hours and hours of energy. With Dan Hawkins and Ish Schroff, that South Florida quarterback B.J. Daniels injured on the Bulls' last scoring drive. South Florida turning a UConn fumble into a Mikon Bonani field goal. And it's 10-6, both these teams winless in the Big East. South Florida trying to snap a 6-game losing streak. UConn has lost 3 in a row. And South Florida this season, and really last season as well, they've had a habit of playing these close, gut-wrenching games, only to have leads in the fourth quarter, see the game tied in the fourth quarter, and have it all slip away. They've got a 4-point lead with less than 8 minutes to play. UConn with the touchback here will start from its own 25-yard line. And, Coach, we've talked about this UConn offense. They've had their struggles this season, but the last few drives, even though they haven't all been scoring drives, you're seeing the Huskies able to move the football a little bit.
The issue that you're having, the last drive, 7 minutes, 39 seconds with 7:53 on the clock, and you need a touchdown, not 3 points. So they're going to have to move it a little bit quicker, and you wonder what the mentality of South Florida is right now as their starting quarterback gets hauled off on a cart, and they've got to defend in the fourth quarter.
Whitmer to the air on first down, incomplete, intended for Griffin. Good coverage there by South Florida. Michael Linares, the linebacker.
See a little shuffling going on in the linebacker core. with Sam Barrington out, and they've done a pretty respectable job.
There's B.J. Daniels being carted off the field. You hope it's not the ankle again. Had to fight through that earlier this season and injured on a quarterback keeper on USF's last drive. Whitmer completes. Shaquem Phillips, the BC transfer, picking up 20. And the Huskies now across their own 45.
Taking a page out of the Syracuse Orange playbook. Syracuse had a lot of success throwing those underneath routes, those dig routes, those post corner routes underneath the top level defenders and behind the secondary level.
The South Florida coaches talked to us about the psychology, I should say the psyche of this defense late in games where they haven't been able to protect leads. Whitmer on the run, incomplete, wanted Phillips again, second and 10.
Showing some really good arm strength. Tayshawn Whitehurst coming off the edge up top. And Chandler booting back out that way. Tayshawn got to be able to stay up and stay on that near shoulder of the quarterback and not let him get outside.
Both teams pretty much even in total yards. UConn 279, South Florida 278. Two tight end set here on second and 10.
Show on the corner blitz again.
McCombs has some room. Dragging defenders, and he's got a UConn first down. A 12-yard run for Lyle McCombs, and that's a much-needed life to this UConn running attack.
It's a good running game, running one-back power. Coming back to the bottom of your screen. Good seam up there. The difference a little bit at McCombs last year, breaking a few more tackles, getting a little few more yards after contact last year than he has been this year.
He had an off the field incident before the Rutgers game, really hasn't produced since then. Whitmer's going to take a shot deep, and there's South Florida's first pick of the season.
The crowd goes wild.
John Legist. There is a flag. There's a couple of flags.
Boy, it was an interception, but that was just not a good throw. Ball came out really bad out of Chandler's hands and just floated that ball.
And Legist, you saw it on the run back from the pick. Wasn't running at full speed. He's hurt.
I think this is going to be a post-possession foul. I think South Florida will remain possession. Ball just floated. South Florida brought pressure from the field.
Okay. After the interception, there are two fouls, both on Connecticut. Illegal block in the back.
72.
Number 72 on Connecticut. After the play is over, personal foul. Late hit out of bounds, number 77. First down.
So those penalties on Jimmy Bennett, the left tackle, and Kevin Friend, the right tackle, but here's South Florida's first pick of the season in the fourth quarter of week 10.
Chandler tried to go channel his inner Roger Staubach with a jump pass right there. Under pressure, ball floats. He's limping already. And you see the block in the back. Doesn't happen very often when you're trying to play defense. And then the late hit out of bounds. So, boy, that is just a big momentum shifter.
So South Florida now with a chance to go up by two scores. They have the ball at the UConn 36-yard line. And there you see the graphic. First interception this season. Coaches talked about it. The players have been talking about it. And it's John Legist, the guy who was demoted from his starting role this year after starting every game the last 2 years. Marcus Shaw, and he's close to a South Florida first down, a pickup of 9, brought down by Ray Wilson. A flag on the play.
That's the play you need with the interception. Sometimes you just need a breakthrough moment. You need a breakthrough play, and sometimes you can call it luck, planning. I've heard all the coach speak.
Holding, offense, number 12, 10-yard penalty, first down.
But you have the interception, the block in the back, the personal foul, you change momentum. Sometimes that can fix your whole season, just a little breath of air.
The penalty moves the ball back to about the 38-yard line. So it'll be first and 12 now for South Florida. Backup quarterback Matt Floyd in the game. B.J. Daniels left the game and was carted off the field, carted off the sidelines after leaving the field as Demetrius Murray gets right back to the original line of scrimmage. It'll bring up second and 10.
Even though they had the holding call in the previous play, you could see a little spark. You just see the guys running around, hustling around, just a little more kick in their step.
We're getting word that no further word on the Daniels injury. We hear something specific. We'll pass that along to you. But right now it's Matt Floyd's team.
Here's where South Florida can afford to be patient, continue to burn clock, and manage that portion of the game.
UConn bringing some pressure, and that's tipped. Leedy Ray Wilson, Scouts Inc. That's Todd McShay's group. They have him rated as the fifth best draft eligible corner. You see why right there.
They're pretty solid on the back end, and sometimes you wouldn't think about not playing in a passing league, but they're very good on the back end, and part of that is the pressure package. You got to think, you get a few yards here, Bonani's probably got another shot to kick a long one here, but you certainly don't want to turn it over and give momentum back to UConn.
Floyd dumps it off to Shaw. He picks up three, but it's going to bring up fourth down. So now you're looking at a 50-yard field goal thereabouts for Mikon Bonani. For his career, he's never hit a 50-yard field goal. This one, though, officially will be from 49. And
you have to root for a guy, though, that was working at the amusement park, fell off the gondola and broke his back and comes back to be a great kicker.
They'll say this is 50, so this will be a career long for Mikon Bonani. And he drills it. .426 left in regulation. South Florida leading UConn by a touchdown and a point after.
No idea as to how I'm going to be paying for college.
I'm the second oldest of 14 children.
Mikon Bonani's 50-yard field goal, a career long, has given South Florida a 7-point lead, but UConn still down by just one score, holding the Bulls to a field goal on that last drive. And South Florida fans, they've seen the heartbreak movie play out a number of times over the past couple of years. Six times since the start of the 2011 season, Skip Holtz's team has had a lead in the fourth quarter, and they've lost the game. UConn trying to get that first Big East win, trying to snap a three-game losing streak. South Florida also winless in the Big East. They've lost six straight since starting the season 2-0. UConn will start at its own 25-yard line. There's a new late-night show on ESPNU, and it's the perfect nightcap to your sports day. Danny Cannell, Reese Waters, and Marianella Perea provide all the latest news and sports with a comedic and social twist. It is Unite, ESPN's first late-night entertainment show, weeknights at midnight on the U. All right, Chandler Whitmer, his turn to be the hero for UConn. Really had been playing well up until the ill-advised throw on the Huskies' last drive.
That and then the turnover they had the previous drive was not helping them.
Whitmer throws, caught by Williams, out of bounds at the 37-yard line. That's a Husky first down.
Really impressive ball, throwing it on time. able to get that good arm strength, good timing. Got to be weighing on the Bulls right now. Can we stop these guys in the fourth quarter?
Whitmer 21 of 32, 248 yards. Less than 4 minutes to play in regulation. On the ground and not much. Tavin Mims all over that.
South Florida bringing six, bringing edge pressure. Able to be picked up. Continue to mix up the calls, which I think is good. And I think pressure is the orientation that this defense likes.
Injured player on the field is the UConn center, Tyler Bullock, and that's not a good sign for what's already a banged up O-line.
Center's the guy that's going to make all your calls up in there. And also just the familiarity of the snap. We saw the snap issues when we had a new quarterback in South Florida. Now Alex Mateus comes in as the backup center.
Mateus, a Penn State transfer. UConn already without Adam Masters, who's their starting right guard, and then was the backup at left guard, left tackle, and right tackle. South Florida blitzes, and UConn's got no answer. Whitehurst came unchecked down the middle.
Really good call. They brought pressure up the middle. Most of the pressure this game has been coming from the outside. Not as much up inside and able to shoot the gap. Taking advantage of a new center in the game, unable to pick up the blitz.
So third and long after South Florida records its third sack of the game.
I think they're in two down territory here.
South Florida again brings the blitz. Whitmer throws, incomplete. Flag on the play.
George Baker on the coverage was not playing the ball. Had his eyes all over the receiver.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 22. The ball be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic. First down.
Just got there early. Shoved him. It's a good call.
And that's a back-breaking penalty for the South Florida defense. And a gift for UConn as now they have a new set of downs. 2:44 to go. The Huskies with two timeouts. Trying to march down the field. They need a touchdown. That's the Davis. He hauls it in near midfield. Another flag at the end of the play. It was Baker again on the coverage.
This is where that experience of Coach Pasqualoni, his staff, you get in those personnel matchups. They got a guy they feel they can pick on. They keep going after him.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 22. Ball be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic. First down.
So two straight pass interference penalties on George Baker.
Got the in route. He's peeking in the backfield and man coverage. Got to keep your eyes on your man. You got him out of the game. Now he starts suffering some confidence issues.
UConn, two timeouts, taking its time here as we have less than 2:30 to play in the fourth quarter. Pressure off the edge, pressure from up the middle, and down goes Whitmer again. Corey Grisham, the one they call Porkchop, gets credited for the sack.
Having issues up inside, showing that late pressure. That's where you have a new center in the game, not able to get that turn and corrected.
Paul Pasqualoni uses his second timeout of the half and stops the clock with 2:11 to go, but that last play resulted in a 9-yard loss. The South Florida defense, it's been much maligned, but they've gotten pressure on the quarterback, getting a turnover there. John Legist coming up with the interception, again, pressure creating that, and then four sacks. On Chandler Whitmer.
Good job answering. Coach has been under fire. Team's been under fire. So far, they're answering.
And for tonight's Wrangler five-star player of the game, we give it to the entire South Florida defense. Five tackles for loss, a fumble recovery, four sacks, and a pick. Their defensive coordinator, Chris Koch, DB's coach, Rick Smith, have all come under heavy criticism for their play. They've stood tall tonight. Whitmer's got a receiver open. It's caught by Davis. And he gets to the original line of scrimmage, so you're looking at third and 10.
Injury in the secondary.
That's why the clock stopped with 2:01. Man down is Chris Bivens Jr.
Chandler Whitmer doing a nice job. South Florida only bringing four, giving Chandler time. They've had a little more success with the pressure, and sometimes that seems a little dicey, but I think Chandler's proven he can carve you up a little bit if he has time. You see South Florida rushing four. UConn protecting with six, five in the running back. Nice job coming back to the ball. Lost some yardage after the catch.
UConn facing a third down. They started 1 for 6 on third down conversions, 3 of 5 since. If the Huskies lose this game, they'll have to win out to become bowl eligible. If South Florida loses this game, they'll be eliminated from the postseason for the second straight year.
Let's see if they go back to work. Normally when you have a DB comes out of the game, you're trying to look at the backup and see if you can go right back at him, have some success.
Again, pressure from the middle. This time UConn picks it up. Whitmer throws. That's hauled in by Smith, and he's out of bounds near the 35-yard line, a first down for UConn.
They were forced to get George Baker back into the game, playing the wide side corner. South Florida comes back with that inside pressure. This time they pick it up with seven guys in the backfield. Really good throw on time, good catch.
And you gotta wonder if that South Florida sideline, the fan base, has that feeling of deja vu as UConn continues to drive. Less than 90 seconds to play. Whitmer over the middle. Incomplete. Dangerous pass.
Only rushing three. T.D. Lattimore had a chance. He knocked it down. He had a chance to pick it. Probably not used to doing that much.
The Huskies don't have a touchdown in this game. They've been held to 2 field goals. Second and 10.
Got Davis at the bottom of the screen. That's been his go-to man.
In traffic. And that's through the hands of Ryan Griffin. Tight end's been a big target in the passing offense the last couple weeks. He can't hold on there. So it's 3rd and 10. And they converted last time on 3rd and 9.
You got to wonder if they're going to come back to that comeback route, the Cobb route. Davis done a nice job going up and battling for the ball. The look for his alignment. He's going up to the right, the top end of the screen. Really tight alignment now next to the hash mark, expecting out throws when you have that bunch look.
There's that out route. Williams hauls it in, makes a man miss. Williams fighting for those extra yards, and he looks to have a UConn first down.
Wow, what a gutsy play. There was that out route, bunched up formation. You see Chandler Whitmer's ability to throw the ball out there. He's got a strong arm. Now that gorilla weighs about 800 pounds sitting on the back of South Florida.
That's not a gorilla, that's Donkey Kong. Whitmer's pass batted down.
And picked
South Florida's defense. Coming up with a huge play again, Elkino Watson. Well, if that was Donkey Kong or the albatross, whatever it was, it just fell to the ground.
He fell off the Empire State Building. Boy, ball just kind of got bounced around there. Hey, look what I found.
Eric Lee got his hands up. Rather, Todd Chandler, and it falls into the hands of big number 53, Elkino Watson.
Good job. You can't get there. Get your hands up and obstruct the view.
How about that? They were the last team in the FBS to come up with an interception. And this defense, much maligned, it's put heat on Skip Holtz, the defensive coordinator, the secondary's coach. And it was this defense which had folded time and again in the fourth quarter. What did it do in the fourth quarter today? How about forcing three turnovers? The McCombs fumble. And then two picks, Legist and Watson. South Florida is going to snap a six-game losing streak. They'll get their first Big East win since knocking off Syracuse last year. They had lost six straight in conference.
If you watched the feature on game day earlier today where they interviewed the coaches about losing and their comments, you can just see the breath of fresh air down there on South Florida's sideline, and you're just trying to find a way to get one more point than the other team and looking for some ray of sunshine, and they got it there.
When we spoke to Skip Holtz, he said, you know, can we just get an interception? Chris Kosh was kind of joking about the voodoo doll that had been hidden somewhere on campus in South Florida, their inability to win these kinds of games.
Not going to get easier. They got to win three more to get into a bowl game. They got a tough schedule coming up. But you can't get there unless you get this one right here. So congrats to Coach Holtz and his staff for pulling it together and holding off a gritty UConn team.
And for UConn, all the questions about their offense, the criticism of George DeLeon and Paul Pasqualoni, that could continue. UConn struggled on offense. They fall to 0-4 in the Big East. They lost four games in a row. South Florida off the schneid. They get that first Big East win thanks to its defense. Coming up next, it's SportsCenter U. They'll have a look at all the great games, including Alabama and LSU, and the Fighting Irish just surviving. We'll be back with a talk with Skip Holtz, the head coach for South Florida. But now we go to Matt Schick and Jason Sehorn in the studio.
Thank you, guys. We will get you back out to South Florida momentarily with another report from Anish and Dan on that big win for South Florida, a team that had lost a half dozen games in a row. As Anish said, nice to get off the schneid. I don't know if Coach Holtz, this will make him feel a little bit better after the schneid, just a little bit. But what can you say about South Florida now? Hey, they could get bowl eligible if they win out. Tough schedule ahead.
Backs against the wall. They had to win the football game to actually be, to have a chance to be bowl eligible. They got the victory. I think more importantly for the defense, having no interceptions all season long, having two in this football game, sets them up for the rest of the season because now you start to gain confidence. And what this football team needs is just a little bit of confidence because what they've got to do ahead is not an easy road to hoe.
A lot was expected of South Florida. They play Louisville tough. They played Florida State tough, just not showing up in the win column. So
yeah, you're not getting a lot of credit for being tough.
No, that's not happening.
They won victories
for South Florida and Coach Holtz. All right, let's stick in the Big East here. We'll get you back out to South Florida in just a couple of minutes. But first,
all right, Matt, we're joined by South Florida head coach Skip Holtz. Coach, what did it mean to win this game with your defense?
It was huge. Like I said, I couldn't have written a better script. I even made the comment earlier, I'd like to win this game and have our defense score a couple touchdowns. But fortunately, we were able to secure a couple of those really tough interceptions that we've had a hard time getting this so far this year. And to get two of them tonight is really, really nice. And to be see us stand up and be able to get a stop at the end of the game, a lot of excitement in these players right now to be as close as we've been, but to be able to finish it off tonight.
What can you tell us about B.J. Daniels' injury?
At this point, I just know it's an ankle. That's all I know at this point. I really don't know. We'll have to evaluate it. If it's just an ankle, we're going to have to see if it's a high ankle, how much swelling we get in it, those type of things as we get ready for the open date this week and then going into Miami.
South Florida getting its first Big East win of the season. Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
Good job. South Florida head coach Skip Holtz. Let's go back to Matt in the studio.